Hey guys, PUNJISTICK here. I know, surprise, surprise, it's been a hot minute since we made a video for YouTube and uploaded it here. But we're doing this video today for two reasons. One, recently, not that long ago, I upgraded my Origin PC EON17-X laptop from a 1080 to a 2080 on my own. First time I've ever done a laptop upgrade like that. And so I was kind of excited about how easy it was and wanted to share it. The second reason is that 2080 that I upgraded to was in fact free from Origin PC. So this video is sponsored, but it's sponsored for a good reason. And I think it'll be a useful video that a lot of you guys might kind of get over the fear of messing with laptops. Everyone can do desktops, right? Those are like just adult Legos, but everyone's scared of laptops still. You shouldn't be. They're really easy. Not all of them are easy, but Origin PC ones are easy. So here goes the video. Here's what we got. Before we get into it, I want to give a shout out specifically to the Origin PC tech support team. This is a sponsored video. I did receive the RTX 2080 for free for this upgrade. However, when it came to actually doing the upgrade, I called them up for help the same way that you would if you needed to upgrade it yourself if you're watching this, and they were great every single step of the way. Once you own one of their products, you get 24/7 US-based free support and labor for life, regardless of the warranty. I didn't get any fancy treatment just because I'm a washed-up Rainbow Six Siege commentator that plays video games for a living. I called their tech support line just like any other customer, and a friendly dude named Sam walked me through the whole process via phone and email, even sending me all the files and instructions I'd need to flash the BIOS to be compatible with the new RTX 2080. Before I actually swapped the GPU, I first had to flash the BIOS twice incrementally to get the laptop to detect the new card. I had no idea how to do this, but their tech support made it a breeze, just like I mentioned above. I'd never flashed a BIOS before this upgrade or swapped a laptop GPU or even heard the word FreeDOS before, and the instructions they gave me were incredibly simple to follow. So once I was done with that, I just ran display to driver uninstaller, shut it down, and started the swap you're about to watch in this video right now. I've done most of my PC upgrades on a rug like an idiot, with screws everywhere in total chaos. Since we're making a video here, I thought for once I'd keep things neat on a table, all pretty for you guys. We get the laptop, of course. We get a new heatsink, compatible with the new GPU, the GPU, a bootable USB for flashing the BIOS, an unnecessary amount of screwdrivers, since we literally only need one Phillips for the entire thing, and I even put a little organizer to keep the screws separated, even though there's only three different kinds from start to finish. Also a monster because I'm an addict, a second laptop for when I mess up and need the internet to save me. Seriously, the only tools you need for this are a Phillips, maybe a flathead to give the panels a little boost, a lint-free rag, rubbing alcohol to clean off the old thermal paste, some new thermal paste, and a bootable flash drive. We're talking a grand total of 16 screws and one cable that need to be removed or disconnected and then replaced. That's it. It's like 4% more difficult than a desktop CPU according to math. First, we're gonna pop out the battery, which is simple. You just press up on the lock and then slide the slide. After that's out, there's four screws along the back, closest to the vents, plus one screw in the middle holding the panel on. Once you remove those five screws, you just slide the panel towards the vents to pop it off. It's really easy, but you might need to lightly wedge a flathead in there to get it started. Now the panel's off, you can wipe off the disgusting dust you've been neglecting like the bad person that you are. For anyone that's ever opened just about any other laptop, you'll notice that everything is right there. I swear you can swap storage and RAM easier on the EON17X than you can in a desktop PC, but more on that later. Once you're done taking in the fact this laptop was actually made to be messed with, you'll notice there are a grand total of 9 screws, and that's it, you'll need to remove in order to get at the GPU. 4 bigger CPU screws, 4 smaller screws around the GPU, and one lonely boy to the right of the RAM that's the same size as the GPU screws. They're even labeled in the order you should remove and replace them. Get all 9 of them out, and you can just lift both heat sinks straight up and off. They've got 2 little handles to make it super easy. You'll notice for my particular upgrade, I'll be going from 2 separate heat sinks to one solid one that does the same job. This is something to look out for if you're changing series of graphics cards, as your current heat sink might not be compatible with a newer card. It's also something I wouldn't have known if it wasn't for the Origin PC guys telling me. You might also notice we're only 2 screws and a cable away from removing the GPU now. Next, remove the 2 silver screws holding the GPU in place, and then pop out the cable. I pushed it along the guide using a flathead. Yes, it has a nice, easy tool guide to pop it out. A guide, not yanking on ribbon cables everywhere. And once it's off, the GPU will pop right up on its own, nice and simple. I replaced the little pad because they sent me one. If it's still clean and nice, you can probably just keep it there. Slap the shiny new card in, but don't actually slap it. I'm actually just being super gentle with it despite my shaky, nervous hands. Don't forget, first time. Clean the old thermal paste off the CPU, replace the two screws in the GPU, reconnect the cable, and apply a fresh thermal paste to both. I use the center P technique. We can fight about it in the comments if you want. My way is right, yours is wrong. Carefully seat the new heatsink, follow the order for replacing the screws, and we're basically done. Slide the cover back on the opposite of how you would taken it off, shocker, and replace the five screws. Pop back in the battery. Side note, this other compartment is separate and only for storage. Held on by two screws, it slides off and exposes both SSD bays as well as the M.2 slot. Like I said, literally faster than easier than swapping storage on a desktop PC. Not a meme. So that's it. I've been using this laptop with the RTX 2080 in it for a bit now, and it's of course running better than ever. For a full list of the specs, feel free to check the description below. I don't upload to YouTube often, but I do always read and respond to comments, so if you've got a question, feel free to ask. I do also, however, stream full-time on Twitch. You can find me at twitch.tv/PUNJISTICK. One last thing. Origin PC is giving away one of their new Eon 15X gaming laptops for free. The link to enter is also in the description of this video. You've got until July 31st to enter. It's free, so you might as well get on it. Thanks again to the Origin PC team for powering all the nerd stuff that I do, and thank you for watching.